We have Dutchland and Montreal in a important bout to see who's going to end up in the fifth or seventh place in these playoffs. Interesting to note what these two teams have done this year, Bet. We've got Montreal and Dutchland. When you compare them to the teams that each of them have played, it's fairly close, although Montreal has played more bouts than Dutchland.
Yeah, they have, and they've also played some really tough opponents. Quite a huge schedule for the Montreal travel team this year, and I think they've really impressed a lot of people with their ability to get better and better as the year goes on.
Who are some of the skaters we want to look for Montreal?
Definitely Iron Wench Jamming and Georgia W. Tush. In the pack, Smack Daddy, Little Mama. We have the first jam starting off, and right away we have Iron Wench jamming for Montreal.
Skid Ho jamming for Dutchland. Iron Wench having a little bit of trouble on the outside. Skid Ho finds her hole on the inside, and she's lead jammer in this first jam of the bout.
Iron Wench gets out of the pack past 12:34. Remen Choke.
Now the action's in the pack as Skid Ho is picking up speed. Going in, she gets around Georgia W. Tush. And no, that was Little Mama she passed, and now she calls off that jam.
Stuck behind the wall of the Montreal blockers in the front of the pack there. Gives it a call just in time.
Skid Ho is going to pick up, we're looking at the scoreboard right now. It looks like it's a 0-0 jam to start things off. This next jam is brought to you by Dr. Hauschka. Dr. Hauschka is the WFTDA's official bruise healer. Lose the bruise with Dr. Hauschka's Ouch Aid.
Actually, I think Dutchland got 4 points on that jam. A little late with the fingers there.
Well, it's been a long weekend, and there's a lot more Derby to come.
Absolutely.
So V Diva now is on the track for Dutchland.
And number 40, Georgia W. Tush for Montreal. Very slow start here. Both teams jockeying for position and waiting to cross that line. V Diva does cross the line, and the jam starts. Ooh.
Tough takedown. That Nash Villain on the line for Dutchland. She goes down again at the hands of Lady J. A lot of action in the pack. These jammers having a hard time, Bet.
Oh, there she is through. Nash Villain. And, Georgia W. Tush getting sent to the box from Montreal. So this is a power jam opportunity for Dutchland.
Nash Villain coming up on the Montreal pack. And that was some serious collision between Nash Villain and Bone Machine.
And Nash Villain getting sent for a major back block to the box.
As a result of that collision, somebody was going to get a penalty on that bet.
Absolutely. And it looks like Georgia W. Tush will be coming out right now.
Trading jammer penalties in the early going. Nash Villain didn't get any points yet. V Diva trying to hold off Georgia W. Tush, and she does, but she's going to get called off for a forearm on that play.
That leaves one blocker, number 40, Scissors for Dutchland.
Twisted Scissors. She's going to to stay away from this pack. That's about the only thing she can do, Bet.
V Diva coming right back in, though. She got waved off from the box. Here comes Nash Villain. She's back in. 60-21 is her number. She is from Dutchland. Georgia W. Tush getting knocked to the inside. Coming in on the inside line, though, and sneaking past. And it is called by Nash Villain.
And that jam was a whole lot of work for 3 points. And those three are going to be going to Montreal.
No, I think it's Dutchland. Yes.
My bad. Yeah.
0-7. We are getting 3 points for Montreal as well. So it's going to be 3-7. Dutchland in the lead. Early minutes of the game here. Montreal taking a knee on the line. They want to get this thing started as quickly as possible because Dutchland have two blockers in the box.
On the track, V Diva and Iron Bella Lelosi for Dutchland. V Diva takes out Iron Wench.
Actually, that's Mange Moi. My fault. Sorry. Mange Moi, number IX. She is trying to get out, and she gets past V Diva, who's sent to the box. Mangeois is lead jammer for Montreal.
White Thrash still trying to get through the pack for Dutchland. And Mangeois with a big advantage in this jam now, as Dutchland still can't spring their jammer.
And here comes Mangeois to the back of the pack. Wall of Dutchland trying to hold her back. She is through on the inside again. 5 points.
Big shot to catch a big crowd approval. Smack Daddy put the smack on White Thrash.
Smack Daddy definitely a blocker for Montreal to watch in that pack.
And now Mangeois looking to pick up some dessert. She already manged her first courses. If you have any knowledge of the French language, we don't have to tell you what Mangeois means. But she's eating up the track right now in this jam.
And it looks like she's trying to get through again for another 5-point pass. Having a little trouble getting past some of the Dutchland blockers there.
Well, that's Milk Maiden.
Milk Maiden, that's
Hillbilly
correct.
And Hillbilly Hellcat, and they're holding her off, but she's already picked up an enormous number of points for Montreal. And
she got a little help from Lil Mama, number two from Montreal, and she is through again. Another 5-point pass.
That's a grand slam, and finally White Thrash clears the pack. She is finally in scoring position, but Mangeois looks at her pivot, Jess Bandit, for instructions as she gets ready to engage this pack one more time.
She's going to go for another round of points. She is knocked out, and she does call it.
Well, that was the jam that Montreal needed. Everything was pretty close up until that one, but Dutchland is a counterpunching team. I would expect to see them regain their composure after that jam and come up with a big one of their own. This next jam is brought to you by Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing solutions.
And once again, Montreal taking a knee on the line.
And we have an official's timeout called, and that gives us another opportunity to thank some of the sponsors for this great streaming video that you've been enjoying all weekend long from the 2011 WFTDA Regional Playoff. And we're in the East, the Beast of the East, the Nightmare on 95. We want to thank Adam Wheels, the official wheel of the WFTDA, and Rydell Skates, proud partner and official skate of the WFTDA. Along with Spenlin Media. You need it, we make it. Apparel, websites, and that fabulous Rules app, Bet.
I need to get that on my phone.
Everybody should have that on their phone. Of course, you know, there's enough controversy in this game without everybody knowing the rules.
Yeah, we have a few fans in London who are already studying their own handbooks so they can get in on the action.
Skid Ho ready to jam once again for Dutchland.
And I think we have Iron Wench for Montreal.
Iron Wench and Iron Jammer for the new Skids. We have a major wall at the front. Can Skid Ho get around? It looks like she's already got the lead jammer set up, but
she is sent to the box. Major track cut. Another power jam for Montreal.
And that's just pesky blocking, effective blocking by Montreal. Skid Ho was actually through and got the lead jammer status, but that did not dissuade Montreal from continuing to put the pressure on her, Bet.
Yep. Looks like Dutchland number 1234, Rum and Choke, trying to hold back Iron Wench, but Iron Wench does get through and she gets her points. And look at that, she's right at the back of the pack again, ready for another pass. And Dutchland trying to run the front of the pack there. Montreal is going to get up there and try to break it up a little.
Rum and Choke along with Twisted Scissors up there for Dutchland. They're trying to put themselves in a position of superior blocking, and it looks like it's actually working. Look at Iron Wench try to get through that wall of two, and she's just not doing it, Beth.
Yeah, getting manhandled by Renegade Raven, number 935 on Dutchland, Rum and Choke, and number 11, Spinal Snap.
Three wall in effect for Dutchland, but now they're going to have to let Iron Wench go, and that's going to be five biggies for the new Skids.
And number 18, Skid Ho, is out of the box. Jammer for Dutchland. Iron Wench is letting her run it down, and she called. Oh, illegal
Iron
procedure.
Iron Wench was not lead
not
jammer.
Lead.
That's what we were trying to say, Bet. Skid Ho had actually become
That's
lead
right.
jammer in that pass, but she never was unengaged by the Montreal blockers. And so Iron Wench continues to score, only picking up a minor.
Oh, look at this, though.
Skid Ho called off for another track cut, and Dutchland's woes are continuing to pile up here in the first. Can't score with a jammer in the box.
And they are going to put Georgia W. Tush out to jam number 40 for Montreal. Montreal, of course, taking a knee. They want to start this jam as quickly as possible.
This power jam is brought to you by Union Vacations. They're proud to provide the 2011 WFTDA MVP with a one-week getaway to Mexico.
Number 2, Lil Mama, and number 3, X Smack Daddy, the only blockers in the pack for Montreal. They're going to do their best against four Dutchland blockers, trying to help number 40, Georgia W. Tush, get through that pack.
Team USA's candidate, V. Diva, out there. And how about that? Another turnaround of jammers in the box. That's going to free Skid Ho. Bella Loblosi out there for Dutchland as well. And Skid Ho tries to go outside. She's knocked silly and back on her feet. But, boy, there's some ferocious blocking taking place here, Bet.
They are going to get that 20-foot call. Skid Ho is through.
Lead jammer Dutchland now slows it down. It's 23-10 in favor of Montreal. And, oh, Skid Ho can't quite keep her inside footing.
There goes Georgia W. Tush. Nobody notices she came sneaking out of that box, and she goes right through, not lead. V. Diva, number 18 for Dutchland, sent to the box.
And Skid Ho calls it off. And Skid Ho is probably happy to sit down after being involved in a couple of jams there. I'm sure it gets pretty exhausting out there when you got to jam for more than two or three jams.
There is nothing like getting hit and bashed around. That makes you way more tired than speeding around the track. And she did manage to eke out a couple points on that last pass, though. So more than Montreal got from that one.
23-12. Of course, if you're just tuning in, Dutchland in their signature orange. Montreal, new skids in the green and Technicolor leggings. Nash Villain now skating on the jam line with the star for Dutchland. Trying to power her way through is T-Loop.
New jammer for Montreal.
Yeah, her first jam of the night, T-Loop. And Nash Villain now gets ridden out by... that was Trash and Smash. Nash Villain gets through, but she's not lead. This is going to put a premium on blocking for Dutchland now.
And here comes T-Loop. She is passing the helmet panty. She has just passed it to number 8, Jess Bandit, who's the captain of Montreal. Jess is out front, and she's trying to get that jammer panty on.
And this is an interesting strategic move. Hey, look at the speed. And T-Lou didn't really give up any speed by passing that jammer panty, although Nash Villain has plenty of speed of her own. She gets through and
manages to pass Jess Bandit.
V. Diva rejoins the action. Nobody can call off this jam now, so this one's going to go the full 2 minutes.
If you're a little confused about what happened there, in this game of roller derby, the jammer can pass off their starred helmet panty to the pivot, the one with the stripe on their helmet.
And only the pivot.
And that's right.
And Nash Villain's now going to have to sit down with four majors. V. Diva trying to hold off Jess Bandit. And Jess Bandit and V. Diva going at it in turn number 4.
Jess Bandit looks like she's getting a little tired on this one. I don't think she's a normal jammer from Montreal.
I wonder whether she expected to get that star at the beginning of the jam, but
she didn't look surprised. I'm not going to say that, but
a skater's going to want that star, I'm sure. When they've got the stripe, the pivot stripe on their helmet, they're probably always going to expect it. And that's it. The jam times out. Not a lot of scoring in that one, but sure a lot of action. 3 points for Jess Bandit on that star pass, Beth.
Yeah, not bad for somebody who's not a normal jammer.
This next jam is going to be brought to you by ProTech Mouthguards, the first thoroughly scientific mouthguard for the Derby player.
And we are starting this jam with a power jam for Montreal.
And the new skids just keep moving backwards, getting that knee down. And tell us about that strategy, Pat.
Well, the knee down creates a no-pack situation, and so the jam starts immediately.
Well, that sure worked to their advantage on that one. That's Iron Wench, and she rocketed from the pack out into lead jam.
And you saw Dutchland trying to form that wall in front of the knee down Montreal players, trying to like get that wall that the jammer runs right into. It did not work in that situation, obviously.
Iron Wench getting ready to engage the pack. She takes a jump to the inside, and Milk Maiden and Bella Loblosi holding her off on the inside. Now Nash Villain is back out there. She's ridden out by Smack Daddy. There's plenty of action in this one. Nash Villain's going to pick up a few points of her own, and makes you wonder whether Iron Wench will call this one or not. Well, she probably won't call it with Nash Villain on the track, but Nash Villain comes right back on the floor. Nash Villain comes right back up.
And Iron Wench coming to that back of the pack again, going for another scoring pass. Might as well.
Look at that move. A little fake left, go right. And she left, I believe it was Milk Maiden, in the dirt. No, that was Jolene Jawbreaker. But Iron Wench showing her skills, Bet.
Yeah, she is a very agile jammer, juking and chopping and changing. And she's got that slender build. She can get through a little opening.
Nash Villain still out there, too, and Nash Villain can continue to score. Just kind of depends now. She's engaging up front as Smack Daddy tries to bridge for her teammate. Now Jolene Jawbreaker goes down.
Oh,
Iron Wench
right
gets around Milk Maiden and Bella Loblosi, and this is a marathon jam, Bet.
Yeah, I think it's almost like Montreal has a power jam here, even though the Dutchland jammer did get out. Nash Villain did come to the back of the pack, and it is called just in time. Don't think she got any points there.
Oh, no, she did. She got 11, actually. That was a...
On that pass.
Oh, yes. On that jam. There are a lot of points being scored. My bad. So, Bet, of course, is coming to us courtesy of, I'm not going to say the airline, but you started off your travels in Heathrow, probably.
I did, yes. I am from London Roller Girls. So.
And it's so great to have you here in Dew Burns, along with your team, the London Brawling. The talk of the tournament so far, the London Brawling girls are just a fantastic team, putting that upset win together against North Carolina, and boy, gutting it out against Philadelphia yesterday afternoon.
Yeah. Absolutely. That second half of the Philly game was amazing, and London is just having a great time here. So excited to be the first European team to make it to a WFTDA Big Five tournament, and you know, we were excited about the Carolina game. It could have gone either way, and the fact that we won was amazing. And you know what? It was my birthday, and that's what I wanted as a present. So.
Well, happy birthday to Bet Noir, and you did get your present, and we all got a present being able to watch the London Brawling team in action. Now we've got V Diva on the jam line for Dutchland.
And number 40, Georgia W. Tush from Montreal. I think this is the first time that V Diva has jammed. Whoa, right through that inside line. Number 18 on your screen. She is fast.
V Diva with a rocket in her pocket, and she is going to town. Georgia W. Push still having a tough time. She's through now. But look at V Diva with that stride, and she can deflect the hits. It's not too often that you're going to knock this skater down. She's stalking Georgia W. Tush.
Absolutely.
Right now. Jammer on jammer action for V Diva as she hits the pack again. Look at that, falling off the jam after getting around a couple of skaters. We'll see whether Georgia W. Tush picked up any points, but that's what Dutchland needed right there, was that sort of splendid performance from V Diva.
I suspect they're going to jam her a few more times after that performance.
Well, we want you to take your league to the next level with Skate Court Roller Derby Flat Tracks. They're skating on Skate Court this whole weekend, Bet.
Yeah, I'm not familiar with the Skate Court, but I wish we could afford one in London, let me tell you.
Well, this next jam starts off, and I tell you, the action is fast and furious. Mangemoi is out there in front for...
Montreal.
Skid Ho wearing the star for Dutchland.
Number 18 versus number IX. And Mangemoi trying to get through. Looking to, like, yep, she is going to get through.
Mangemoi.
Past Rum and Choke.
and Skid Row is going to be called off for a fourth minor. It's a track cut, and that sets the table for Montjamois.
Montreal doing a good job of trapping one of the Dutchland blockers there.
Bella Loblosi working hard against Montjamois. Now she's got some help from Rum and Choke, but they're outside the engagement zone. They're going to have to let her go.
And they do. That is a 5-point pass for Montjamois. Montreal trying to hold back Spinal Snap, but they do let her go. So they're just going to try and, oh, it looks like a... Yeah.
Lil Mama has to sit down. The penalties are piling up for both of these teams, but it doesn't bother Montjamois. That's going to be another high five grand slam for Montreal.
Smack Daddy getting sent to the box for Montreal. Number 3X, that was her fourth minor, so she goes to the box as well. Iron Wench engaged in the pack, 2 versus 2. Knocked to the outside by Bella Loblowski. The jam is called off.
It's actually Loblosi. Trying to stylize the name after the famous horror movie star. Our next jam is brought to you by Derby Skins. Derby Skins loves making your hiney shiny.
Ooh.
And if you haven't ever had the shiny hiney treatment, you're going to love it. And go check out Derby Skins. You're going to be glad you did.
The power of the sparkly hot pants, people.
And many derby skaters have known that power for a long time. And speaking of power, Bet, Montreal's starting this jam in a power jam situation.
That's right. Number 516, Iron Wench, barreling around that track again. Obviously, she is lead jammer. Skid Ho coming out of that box. Meanwhile, she has re-entered.
Well, it's a small pack for both teams, but a fierce pack for Montreal. Skid Ho finding the going a little difficult, and she's still ridden out as Iron Wench tries to do a little blocking of her own, and the Montreal pivot is engaged as well. That's Cheese Grater,
yep.
And I don't know why she doesn't go by Fromage, but maybe she does to her friends.
Yeah, when you see Iron Wench doing a little blocking there at the front of the pack, we call that eating the baby. I don't know where that comes from, but that's what it's called in the derby world.
It was effective. Skid Ho continues to keep her balance. She's going to be scoring a few now, but...
Iron Wench still out. She gets out first. Skid Ho got knocked down, and she is at the back of the pack again. She's going to have to face that wall of Smack Daddy and Lady J.
And Bella Loblosi tries to break it up along with Rum and Choke, but I tell you, Iron Wench is just the jammer of the period.
Look at her go again.
How about it? She picks up another grand slam for Montreal, and that extends the Montreal lead 73-32.
Iron Wench is having an on-fire few jams here, definitely.
Skid Ho for a major track cut. She looks up at the heavens and says, how did that happen? But
she is having a rough time with those majors, isn't she?
Oh.
And if I was the bench coach for Dutchland, I'd be like, have a seat for a second. V-Diva, get up here. Yeah. We need another one of those.
Dutchland picks up a couple on that, but Montreal picked up a whole basketful to take a 78-34 lead with 9 minutes and 30 seconds left in this one. This next jam's brought to you by 5 on 5 Magazine, the official magazine of WFTDA, 5on5.com.
And number 40, Georgia W. Tush jamming for Montreal.
Power jam against Hillbilly Hellcat and Twisted Scissors, I believe. No, it's Renegade Raven.
Renegade Raven. There goes Georgia. She is out. Lead, obviously. Power jam for Montreal.
A little bit of help coming from the penalty box now for Dutchland.
And Montreal have 4 blockers on the track. They have stopped number 935 and number 11 Spinal Snap. Georgia still having trouble getting through, though.
Yeah, Dutchland's starting to solidify the defense. It's Milk Maiden, Spinal Snap, Renegade Raven, and
I'm not sure who that fourth one is yet. I can't see them.
We'll catch the number this time around. Hillbilly Hellcat.
There you go.
And Georgia W. Tush continues to have a little difficulty with that three-wall, but now she gets through on the inside, Beth.
And Montreal does manage to catch number 935, Renegade Raven from Dutchland, and slows that pack down. Here comes Skid Ho, number 18, the jammer for Dutchland. She's going to try it again. Knocked to the inside by Bone Machine.
And Georgia W. Tush bounces right off of the Milk Maiden and keeps on going.
Whoa, there goes Skid Ho, though. She is going to get through this time.
Not lead jammer, and in a position that she really has to turn on her rockets, because Dutchland down now by 54 points, and Georgia W. Tush not unexpectedly calls that one off, Beth.
At the right time. Excellent jam for Georgia W. Tush.
We want to thank Wicked Skatewear. They're here in the building if you want to come down tomorrow to watch the championship or the regional championship game, and say hi to B-Train and Strychnine. Also, this next jam is brought to you by Sin City Skates. They're ready to fix your gear or chat about new stuff. 7:19 left on the period clock. We have an official's timeout called, Bet. What do you see so far in this one?
Well, Montreal started a little bit slow. They didn't have a great game this morning, and I think they just needed to warm up and kind of feel that juice flowing. But they are playing great the past 10 minutes here. Dutchland having a little bit of trouble controlling the pack and working that defense. And obviously, Skid Ho getting sent to the box for those major track cuts is not helping at all.
The story of the period, in, to begin with, is that a whole, you can't score with your jammer in the penalty box situation, and between Skid Ho and a couple of the other Dutchland jammers, it's just been tough. And penalties have been called pretty liberally on both of these teams. There have been a lot of 2-on-2 and 3-on-3 situations out there, Bet, but definitely Montreal's had a better chance and a better luck as far as keeping their jammers on the track, and they're picking up points in buckets when they pick them up.
Absolutely. And, you know, Montreal does have its fair share of problems going to the box. You know, look out for Little Mama. I think she's been there already. And she does tend to get a little close to those seven major trips to the box. If you get seven majors, you will be fouled out of the game. So if that happens in the first half, she's gone. If it happens in the second half, there you go.
Well, we've got V Diva once again, only her second jam of the bout. And Dutchland might be saving her for the second period a little bit, but I think that they could use a little magic right now, Bet.
And a slow start off the line. Montreal trying to draw it out. They got that last blocker just passing the pivot line, and the whistle is blown for the jammers. V Diva doing a little defensive action. She's going to see what she can do against T-Loop.
T-Loop with a nice move to the inside and then out, but V Diva's going to make it through first. But I tell you, T-Loop was right on V Diva's tail. She's opening herself up, and that's going to mean that V Diva's going to have to hit this pack hard in order to get a few points, and more importantly, not to give Montreal any more.
V Diva powering around that track, showing why she was chosen to represent Team USA in the World Cup coming up in December.
Jolene Jawbreaker doing her job in the back of the pack as jammer killer. V Diva picks up three, calls off the jam, and Dutchland's going to need to see a little bit more of that to crawl back into this one. Of course, still plenty of time in the first period, 6 minutes. If you're just tuning in, this is Dutchland versus Montreal, and Dutchland, of course, in the orange, Montreal in the green with the Technicolor leggings. This next jam is brought to you by Iron Doll Clothing, one-of-a-kind uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee.
Immediate start, Montreal taking a knee again.
And that seems to be working for Montreal in the early going. Iron Wench out in front for the new skids. She's running into a three-wall up front of orange. How about that shot?
And some nice blocking at the front, but but she is through.
Iron Wench takes a licking, and it doesn't bother her a bit. That's White Thrash wearing the star for Dutchland. She's knocked to the inside and by Lil Mama, and now Iron Wench finds herself in scoring position again.
White Thrash trying to get past Jess Bandit at the front of the pack there, getting manhandled a bit to the inside, to the outside. And meanwhile, here comes Iron Wench. She's looking for the outside line, a little help from Lil Mama.
She engages Milk Maiden and Bella Loblosi for just a second. Doesn't see anything there. Bella Loblosi riding her out to the outside, and good positional blocking so far for Dutchland. Iron Wench having a difficult time. Now she gets through.
Jess Bandit doing an amazing job holding back the Dutchland jammer at the front for a while there, but eventually both jammers are through. No lead for Dutchland, and so Montreal is going to call it off as the jammer reaches the back of the pack.
Well, the defensive blocking for Dutchland is actually quite good here, Bet, but you can only hold off a jammer for so long, and that's one of the difficulties when the jammer for Dutchland doesn't make it through for a while. You can hold her off and hold her off, but not forever. We don't see the skaters on the jam line right now. Looks like Nash Villain for Dutchland.
I think we have Georgia W. Tush, number 40, for Montreal jamming.
Well, this should be an interesting jam. Two skaters with the low centers of gravity, a lot of agility, and a lot of speed. A lot of heart as well, and they've got a lot of respect for each other. They're kind of checking each other out, seeing which line they're going to take. Oh. Now Nash Villain goes inside. She picks up lead.
Georgia playing a little slow defensive action, but it doesn't work. Everybody gets a little psyched out, and Nash Villain is straight through. Georgia W. Tush trying to power around that track and get to her.
Hillbilly Hellcat rejoining the fray now, and in the jammer killer position, Hillbilly Hellcat rides her out.
Guess what? Major track cut. Nash Villain is sent to the box for Dutchland. She thought she was going to get a point off that. Instead, she got a major track cut and only 2 points.
Oh, my.
Montreal fans going a little bit wild on that one in the audience here. I think we got a lot of Montreal fans in the house today.
Well, as again, you guys came from all the way across the Atlantic Ocean. Montreal had to get passports and get everything to come down. I think everybody really appreciates the growing international nature of the sport. And, it's just a lot of fun to see people from different countries coming here and competing in the 2011 WFTDA East Regional Playoff.
And Mange Moi, number 1X. Oh, no. She is getting sent to the box for a fourth minor. That was an amazing opportunity that is now blown for Montreal.
And Nash Villain is known to come back from these types of setbacks with a more determination.
Oh.
She hops, can't quite keep her skates under her, though. And Bella Loblosi holds off Little Mama in the back. So far, Nash Villain not being able to make it through, though. And now she looks for the inside.
She's going to come up that inside. And Smack Daddy's there to ride her and trying to hit her to the outside again, followed by Lil Mama.
Lil Mama had her number the whole time.
Mange Moi right through the pack. Nobody from Dutchland notices her come out of the box. She is not lead.
But she has a head of steam, and she's coming after the pack now. Blocking up front. Just, how about that pirouette?
Nash Villain
comes
through.
Nash Villain, but she will be called off for a low block. That's...
Yep, she got a low block on Smack Daddy there. So Mange Moi is through for a 5-point pass. And unfortunately, again, for Dutchland, this is a power jam for Montreal. And they are taking advantage of it right now. They've really slowed that pack down. And there goes Mange Moi right around the outside. Another 5-point pass for Montreal.
Montreal hits the 105 mark. Yeah, the pack has virtually gone nowhere.
Totally dead. Another 5 points for Montreal.
She splits the uprights. Only two blockers on the track. Now three for Dutchland.
Dutchland thinks they're through, but unfortunately two of their blockers just came in out of the box, and it's slowed again, and the jam is off. Mange Moi tries to take a leap to the inside, and it looks like number 99, Bella, is getting sent to the box.
Bella Loblosi has just come off the bench, or off the penalty box, and she immediately gets sent back. That's the story. of this first half. 30 seconds left. This next jam's going to be brought to you by Vanilla Derby. Let Vanilla Derby take you to success with their brand new top grain leather Renegade and straight jacket boots.
Officials timeout. Sorry, go ahead.
Also Anik boots, reckless wheels, and moto bearings. They are revolutionizing roller derby. We also want to thank FGS. They're the industry pioneer in boot sizing and configuration for women's feet. Split last and narrow skates are in stock and ready to ship to you.
That's what I skate on, split last. Love saying it.
And the officials are in the process. We have Pat Smear here from Montreal, and he's going to give us a rundown as soon as we have a word on what the discussion is about in front of this pack.
And we have the Montreal Jammer in the box, and we have the Dutchland Jammer in the box, and I suspect some of the discussion is about what's going on there, who belongs in the box, who's coming out, whose power jam is this.
And you can see by the looks on the Montreal players' faces, they are intensely into this game. They played earlier today. They had a thrilling win against Carolina. A comeback win, Bet.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I just wanted to let you guys know that at the halftime, the Rev Al is going to interview Crazy Dukes of Providence Roller Derby. So make sure you tune in for that. I've seen Crazy Dukes walking around here and checking out the Derby, and it'll be good to hear from her and see what Providence is up to.
It's just too bad that we can't have more teams here at the East Region playoffs, because if you haven't seen Crazy Dukes skate in action, you're missing a treat. She is a powerful jammer.
She's crazy.
She's crazy. And she wears literally Daisy Duke shorts.
And denim Daisy Dukes.
It was explained to me early in my announcer career that only a very confident skater wears denim, because if you get knocked down, it's not a pleasant situation. But
well, it's not very flexible either. You know, there's a reason everyone wears those sparkly derby skins, hot pants. Let me tell you,
well,
they move.
Speaking of derby skins, we want to thank them for sponsoring our broadcasts this weekend. Derby Skins loves making your hiney shiny, Beth.
Shiny hiney. Power of the derby.
And
we're still waiting for the officials to have their little discussion and let us know what's going on here.
I hope you all have been watching all of these bouts, but especially that last one between Charm and Philly. What an outstanding bout.
What a second half, hey?
Along those lines, if you buy the high definition feed for these bouts, you are able to access all of the tournament bouts on demand. And, you know, there are going to be a lot of, even more exciting bouts before this weekend is over with. So if you've been limping along watching the low-level feed, I know it's good. And I've been watching the low-level feed here when I haven't been announcing. But if you buy that high-def feed, you get to watch those bouts on demand, Bet.
And the jam has started again. We didn't get an official explanation yet, but it doesn't matter. We're going to pay attention to this jam right here. And came out of the box first was the Montreal jammer. Dutchland's going to have to let her go on the 20-foot call, so she's going to get lead. That is Mwanjwa, number IX for Montreal.
And penalty problems continue to pile up for Dutchland. Renegade Raven's going to have to sit down. That leaves Twisted Scissors and Rum and Choke to fend off Mwanjwa. And so far, they're doing it, but now they've got to let her go. And
here comes Nash Villain out of the box, number 6021, the jammer for Dutchland. She has hit the back of the pack, trying to get around all of those Montreal blockers, not having much luck. And here comes Mwanjwa for a scoring pass right through the inside. Dutchland not paying attention, trying a little offense there and missed the defensive opportunity.
And that's five more for Montreal. They run the lead up to 120-39. Nash Villain engaging the pack now. But Another penalty called, this time on Majumois. She and Twisted Scissors leave the track, and that's going to allow Dutchland to at least try to regain a little momentum going into the second period, as Nash Villain out on her own in a power jam for the rest of this jam. We're looking at the jam clock. There's 25 seconds left, actually 25 seconds right now. And Nash Villain, we're going to have to see how many points can one jammer score in 25 seconds, Bet.
Yeah, that was pretty amazing. She just went down on one knee on the inside, but came back in. Oh, she gets knocked to the outside, but she's able to come back in as the Montreal blocker goes to the ground.
And that five for Dutchland, a much needed five going into halftime. Look at
I think she only got four, actually. Still, much needed, right?
And that's it. The jam times out. That's it. The first period is in the books. Montreal 120, Dutchland 43. We will have the second half of this bout for you in 10 minutes. But in the meantime, we want to thank a couple more of our sponsors. Five Stride Skate Shop, the preferred skate shop, get this, of Bonnie Thunders, Deranged, Psychobabble, Susie Hot Rod, and the Philly Phenom, Teflon Donna.
Yeah, that's a pretty good roster of people right there. I don't know if you've heard of those skaters, but they're kind of good. Yeah, I think they know their skates. Don't forget, stick around here. We're going to have an interview in a second with Crazy Dukes of Providence.
And we're coming to you live from the Dew Burns Arena. This is WFTDA and Blaze Streaming Media's live coverage of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs. This is Max the Axe. I'm here with
Bette Noir from London Roller Girls.
And we will be psyched to bring you this second period just in a couple of minutes. Okay, we're back at Dew Burns Arena with the second period of Montreal Dutchland. Bet, what did you see in that first period?
I saw Montreal coming out and after a few jams starting to dominate that game. I think most people expected that. Dutchland definitely taking this game very seriously, though, and really fighting hard for it. V Diva, definitely an effective jammer for Dutchland, and you can see her lining up on the jammer line already, getting ready to start off the second half with a powerful, powerful jam, I'm sure she's hoping.
Power jam situation, as plenty of players for both teams have been sitting down. Dutchland will start this second period with one player in the box. That's number 40, Twisted Scissors, and Montreal starting with three in the box.
We just got another one on the track, though, so actually now they've only got two in the box.
But that's 11-11 Bone Machine stepping out there, and that's, I'm sure, a welcome addition for the new skids from Montreal. If you're just tuning in, Montreal in the green with the Technicolor tights and
the Dutchland, fabulous power of the Technicolor tights.
It seems to be working for them so far. They've got a 120-43 lead, and if you had to have a recipe for Dutchland in this second period, I would say it is more V Diva. What's going on with that skate on the pivot line, Bet?
Well, everyone else who's a blocker must line up behind the hips of the pivot if the pivot is on the line. So she was really trying to push him back. Here comes V Diva on the outside, number two. Lil Mama knocking her as she's up again so quick.
And V-Diva called off for a major back block. And sometimes your power is your own worst enemy.
Absolutely.
And V-Diva learns that lesson there. That springs Montjamois from the penalty box for Montreal.
Number IX, Montjamois. She is trying to fight past the wall of Dutchland blockers at the front there. Not getting much help yet, but here comes number 11-11, Bone Machine, trying to help her out a bit.
And that wall up front, Rum and Choke, trying to hold off Montjamois. They can't do it forever, and they get sucked into the back outside of the 20-foot engagement zone. They have to let Montjamois go, and now it's a power jam for Montreal.
Montreal blockers doing a textbook job there for about half a lap. capturing one of the Dutchland players. They did let her go, though. And so now Mangemoi has to try and get through with a little, not much help right now. Oh, here comes Smack Daddy to the front, trying to help out, do a little offensive blocking, make some holes for Mangemoi. 18-18. Oh, here goes V Diva right out of the box. Nobody notices, and she gets a pass there. No points, though.
Hillbilly Hellcat with a huge jammer takedown. 12-18. Hillbilly Hellcat on Mangemoi. But that's going to end the first jam of the second period. This next jam is brought to you by Derby Supply. They have the best customer service in the business, period.
And lining up to jam for Montreal, we have, it looks like, number 40, Georgia W. Tush.
Up front for Dutchland, we've got Bella Loblosi, Renegade Raven, Milk Maiden, and we have a slow start. What's going on there, Bet?
Well, Montreal is trying to string out that start. They've got somebody in the box, and they want her to come out. Oh, I was wrong. Actually, it's not Georgia W. Tush. It's number two, Lil Mama, jamming for the first time for Montreal, playing a little defensive jammer-on-jammer action there.
And it's 16, White Thrash, jamming for Dutchland.
Oh, Lil Mama
goes down in a pile. Somebody might get called off for that one.
I thought she might have got a back block on that, but no, she is still in. Looks like she's going to try and come up the inside there. She's still playing defensive action, but no, she's going to go for it. Number two, Lil Mama, through the pack, lead jammer for Montreal.
And Renegade Raven was called off for a low block. That one could have gone either way, I suppose, but the referee has to make a call. Now White Thrash gets through for Dutchland.
Number 16, White Thrash, powering around that track, trying to catch up with Lil Mama. Lil Mama, number two, goes around the outside and gives it a call. Only 1 point on that pass, but no points for Dutchland.
And at this point, Montreal will take that with a commanding 82-point lead. Running the clock and picking up 1 point is not a bad result for the new Skids. V-Diva on the line again, wearing the star for Dutchland.
And Montreal taking a knee right in front of that jammer line. They're setting themselves up to be an immediate wall in front of V-Diva. She's so tall, I honestly think she could just hop right over them if she really tried.
I think vaulting the line might not be such a bad idea, but instead she tries to bull her way through, and she's called off for another major back block, and I think that's just frustration against V-Diva. She holds her helmet and says, oh, shoot.
And number A00U, T. Lou, is through and lead jammer for Montreal.
That reminds me of a Zydeco song, T. Lou, and she has that Zydeco rhythm to her skating. She gets out in front and one skater to beat, and she gets
there
around
she
Hillbilly Hellcat, and she's off to the races. That's five more for Montreal.
This jam is not going. Actually, this beginning of the second half is not going the way that Dutchland wanted. Unfortunately, V-Diva bedeviled by the back block major. I think you're right. It's aggression, isn't it, really? She's skating hard.
Absolutely. And you see that wall of green in front of you, and you know you've got the strength to bull those people out of the way, and it's hard not to.
And Dutchland has to let T. Lou go. 20-foot call, and they're getting a penalty on Renegade Raven, number 935. She's going to the box for Dutchland.
And another penalty as Rumen Choke has to sit down.
Wait a minute. All the Dutchland players just got sent to the we still have one on the deck.
That's
wow.
Number three, Jolene Jawbreaker, and she's out of position. So this is a real serious blow to the Dutchland All-Stars. V Diva to the rescue, though. She sprung from the penalty box, and she's going to try to make up for a lot of lost time. Look at her pursuing T. Lou.
Major confusion of the blockers there. It was like we had two different packs on the track at one time. No pack, definitely. In order to have a pack, you must have a majority of skaters with at least one from each team within a 10-foot zone. And so when you see the team separate on the track, you have a no-pack situation, and nobody is allowed to engage the jammer. And that's why you see them going right through when something like that happens.
That was, it didn't resemble a pack. It didn't even resemble a loose gathering. It was just some players on different parts of the track, and we have an official's timeout. While we find out what the officials are talking about there, I want to remind you that another great sponsor for the regional playoffs this weekend is Merch Mama. They're supplying swag to the Derby Nation, and you can check them out on merchmama.com. We also want to let you know that if you are a Warrior, Bet, are you a Warrior?
Sure, yeah.
Hey, well, you sign up for the Warrior Dash in your area. Look it up on warriordash.com. I'm not sure that I really have what it takes to be a Warrior myself. I've heard people talk about it, and I think it's like a 5K run that involves obstacles and
you know what?
People shooting you and stuff.
If I could do it on roller skates, it might be a little easier. I don't know.
On roller skates is certainly the way to give it a try. The Dutchland Jammer getting ready to go now. You can see her 6021 Nash Villain. She's got her game face on. She's looking down there. She knows with the 141-44 in Montreal advantage that if Dutchland's going to get something going, they've got to get it going right now, Bet.
Unfortunately, she's lining up next to number 516 Iron Wench, who has been one of the best jammers of this game so far. So that's going to be a tough battle, of course.
Iron Wench is, well-named, a wiry skater.
Absolutely.
You look at her, and if you didn't realize the athletic ability there, you might think that, she would be easy to knock around and knock off her stride, but quite the opposite. She has a lot of good balance, a lot of just good instincts as to which way to approach the pack, and most people that try to hit her, they either miss or the impact comes back to go against them. We also want to thank Flying Dog. Flying Dog is the official beer of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs. And we get a good close-up of V Diva sitting down right now on the penalty box for Dutchland. No, that's just on her regular bench. My bad.
She's just taking a breather there. It's okay.
V Diva taking a breather, saying hello to the fans out there. You can see more V Diva as Team USA gets ready to engage in the upcoming World Cup matches.
And if you are a fan of Derby and you think you can pick all the winners for the WFTDA Big Five regional playoffs, then you should go to the WFTDA website and fill out your own bracket. It's too late to do it for this tournament because obviously we already have results. But
you'd have a pretty good leg up on a lot of the people. There have been a couple of upsets, including that wonderful London versus Carolina first rounder.
I think that I saw some stats that the brackets after that game, out of like 500, only 121 people got it right. So they're already crying. What can I say? But you could have a chance to pick the winners for the rest of the Big Five tournament. So make sure you go to the WFTDA.com website and fill out your bracket and enter the competition.
And you know what's great about it, Bet? It's free.
Absolutely.
It doesn't cost you a thing. Now, most people do brackets for the NCAA tournament, I know. We're getting ready to go back to action, finally. And I think Nash Villain going up against Iron Wench could be a marquee jam. Both teams only with two in the pack right now. That's going to expose the speed of both of these jammers, Bet.
And just to let you know, the official timeout was just to clarify what happened in that last jam because there was a lot of confusion. But it stands as it is on the track right now, so what you see is correct. And Montreal slowing that down a little, getting another blocker out of the box, helped them out.
1-1-1-1 Bone Machine again. Iron Wench and Nash Villain showing each other a lot of respect.
Totally stopped there. Nash Villain was just kind of hanging out behind her, saying, "Okay, what you gonna do?"
Well, and she got sucked into the booty block of number two, Lil Mama.
Yeah.
And that springs Iron Wench. Iron Wench out in front. Nash Villain finally gets through for Dutchland. Now look at Iron Wench evading two blockers. Hillbilly Hellcat going to have to go off the track now. Renegade Raven rejoins the fray, and just like that, Iron Wench calls it off.
Oh, Iron Wench taking a little spill in front of the penalty box there. Oh, sorry, right, going back to her bench. She's okay, don't worry, folks.
Yeah, we also want to thank Vitamin Water. Vitamin Water has donated the hydration to the skaters and officials for this entire weekend of Derby action, Bet.
I love me some Vitamin Water.
Well,
hey. I'll take 40 ounces of that in the form of Georgia W. Tush. Oh, look at that. What a joke. Georgia, number 40.
White Thrash on the jam line for Dutchland. Another 2-2 pack to start this one off, Bet.
And Montreal stringing it out again and then forming that defensive wall does not work. Number 16, White Thrash, is straight through. She is lead jammer for Dutchland. And number 40, Georgia W. Tush, getting barreled around at the back, getting a little help from Smack Daddy there.
Bella Loblosi and Milk Maiden, the only Dutchland blockers out there now. But look at White Thrash. She's getting around on the outside. That's going to be four points, as Lil Mama continues to jam four. Oh, no. My bad again. Number 40, George W. Tush, jamming for Montreal. So 4 points for Dutchland. They're going to need more than four at a time, though, to make up this 102-point lead.
And we're going to see an interesting jammer from Montreal. Coming on to jam is number 3X Smack Daddy. This is the first time she's jammed tonight. And number 1818 V Diva once again jamming for Dutchland.
Well, I think V Diva is going to continue to see this type of wall formation at the beginning of the jam until she can just kind of chain in that aggression. Looks like she's doing it this time. She gives a little bit of a shoulder block and bursts her way through. She's lead jammer. Dutchland continuing to hold back Montreal's jammer, but she gets through now. That's 3X Smack Daddy in her first jam of the night.
And here comes V Diva trying to get through the front of the pack there. T Lou, number 1X, holding her back, but she manages to power around. She goes to the inside and I think she's going to get a... No, she did not get a call there. I
V
thought
Diva
she got something.
With 4 for Dutchland, and Smack Daddy has to sit down. Power jam for Dutchland with V Diva on wearing the star. That's what the All-Stars need right now if they're going to claw their way back.
This is a great opportunity for V Diva to score some points.
Five.
She's got to keep it under control here. No back blocking this time, right?
Five big ones as Dutchland tries to slow the pack down. They got a Montreal skater caught in the back, and that's going to clear some room for V Diva. Can she take the inside? Lil Mama to beat.
Lil Mama
holds her off, and V Diva calls it off. That's the great thing about roller derby, ladies and gentlemen, is it's a sport for all sizes and all types of skaters. Lil Mama, who goes probably 5'3", V Diva, who's almost 6 feet tall, and Lil Mama was actually able to use her size to her advantage on that last play, Bet.
Lil Mama is a deceptive player. She is a powerful blocker. I've seen her take down many people.
And
quick start for the jam as Montreal takes a knee.
9:35, Renegade Raven in her first jam for Dutchland. She's got a skater to beat, and let's see if she can go on the inside. She does, and she
takes out 289 Cheese Grater.
Cheese Grater looked like she was looking for an inside move. Renegade Raven took her to the outside. Renegade Raven in a power jam now. Smack Daddy getting ready to come back on. Now the Montreal jammer is back. That's 3X Smack Daddy, but Renegade Raven is in scoring position. She's going to try to make it through.
Oh, and she does. She sneaks through that line.
Renegade Raven, where was she earlier? She's jamming to great profit. Bella Loblosi trying to hold off 3X Smack Daddy. Smack Daddy finally gets through. Renegade Raven with 4 points for Dutchland. Now she's looking for more.
She's got a couple already, and can she get through those last two blockers, number 86 and number 289? She's passed on the 20-foot call.
Nash Villain tries to hold off Smack Daddy. Now it gets into Bella Loblosi and number 12, Milk Maiden. Dutchland trying to speed up away from Smack Daddy. And meanwhile, Renegade Raven continues to run the table for Dutchland, Bet.
She is super fast. I got to ask the same question. Why was she not jamming until now? I mean, I know she's a great blocker in the pack, but she is... skating to great effect in this jam, and that's definitely what Dutchland needs to see.
She's on the outside. She's able to hold her balance. Oh, but now she's set up for a jammer block by Smack Daddy. Smack Daddy and Pivot 289. She's greater setting up Renegade Raven for that shot, but Renegade Raven still on her feet, and now she calls it off, and that's just what Dutchland needed. And they picked up some ground there, 155 to 75.
17 and 52 left in the game. If they keep it up like that, they could chip away at some of that Montreal lead. And I don't think Montreal is going to let that happen very easily. And they look like they got their game faces on for this one.
Well, they certainly don't want it to happen. T. Lou is on the jam line for Montreal. Again, if you're just tuning in, Montreal in the green, Dutchland in the orange. Montreal with that 155 to 76 lead. T. Lou looking inside. She picks up lead jammer, gets around Skid Ho.
And white thrash number 16 for Dutchland, getting knocked to the outside by number two, Lil Mama Montreal, and she's going to have to re-enter and come back at that pack from the back. But meanwhile, A00U, T. Lou, has come up to the pack, and she's ready for that scoring pass, trying to fight her way through the middle there, getting a little help from her team, and she is through again. 5 points for Montreal on that pass.
White Thrash has to make it through this pack, Bet. She just can't allow, at this point in the game, T. Lou to essentially skate unopposed.
She's getting a little manhandled at the back of the pack there. Got knocked to the inside and had to back up and come on. Oh, meanwhile, T. Lou down and up again through the pack for another five-point pass for Montreal.
And White Thrash continues to have a difficult time with 2x4, no holds barred, along with Lil Mama. Lil Mama just and there goes a bunch of skaters going down. But T. Lou continues to stay on her feet and score points for Montreal.
And looks like she's going to get through that inside again. Oh, she tried to get a little help from number eight, Jess Bandit, and she actually went down. I think they were so focused on pushing forward that they both went down.
Well, she might have caught Jess Bandit's skate, but she doesn't lose any points for that, and that's another 5 points for T. Lou. And just when it looked like Dutchland was going to be putting themselves in a position to come back in this thing, T. Lou comes out screaming for the new skids.
White Thrash, number 16, just got sent to the box as the jammer for Dutchland. So not only does it look like a power jam, now it officially is a power jam.
T. Lou with a one. This has got to be a 25-point jam and a timely big jam for the Montreal New Skids.
Well, I think we did say at the beginning of this jam that it looked like they had their game faces on and they were going to go for it, and I think they just did.
15 minutes left in the period, and we want to thank Honest Tea for sponsoring these bouts this weekend. Honest Tea is available at the snack table here. It's donated for the volunteers, and Honest Tea is just what they say it is. It's Honest Tea.
And the jam has started again. Number 516, Iron Wench, jamming for Montreal. She gives a little push to the inside and tries to get through.
Hillbilly Hellcat rides her out and then gets knocked down for her efforts, but she's right back up, Bet.
And Iron Wench battling through that front wall of orange, trying to get a little help from her teammates. Ray Volver, number 38 from Montreal, tried to open a little hole for her, but it didn't quite work. Dutchland doing a great aggressive defensive job on this jam, but they are probably gonna have to let her go there.
And that was Twisted Scissors, who's trying to hold off Iron Wench, but can't quite do it. And Milk Maiden is going to have to be spending some penalty time. She picked up her fourth minor.
And Smack Daddy, number 3X, also in the penalty box for Montreal. So there's only two blockers for Montreal on the track. And here comes number 16, White Thrash, the jammer for Dutchland, out of the box, right to the back of the pack. Montreal has seen her, and they are doing a good job of holding her while Iron Wench tries to get through. But here goes number 16, White Thrash. She is through. No lead, and I think that was her first pass, so she's not scoring anything yet.
Nope, no points being held up by the jam ref, but White Thrash is getting ready to hit the pack.
Too late. Iron Wench calls it.
And what, just for good measure, Jess Bandit, pivot, puts a hit on her. But I think Jess Bandit's going to be called for an out-of-play block or a low block. Can't tell which, but she's going to have to sit down now. And I tell you, that penalty timer is going to probably need a drink after this bout. They are really busy, Bet.
Yeah, and I don't think the audience liked that call very much. We got a lot of boos on that call for number 8, Jess Bandit, captain of Montreal, going to the box there. And looks like we've gotten V Diva, number 18, jamming for Dutchland again. Let's see if she can.
Georgia VW Tush, number 40.
Oh.
V Diva gets bounced to the outside. Doesn't hurt her momentum a bit. She
almost doesn't touch anyone. She's just right around that outside. And those long legs, she is just powering. Look at that stride that she has. And she gets down so low. Real speed skater stance there. Georgia W. Tush getting manhandled by number 935.
V Diva on the outside. And she picks up a four-point pass. And
number 2, Lil Mama, getting sent to the box. And Georgia W. Tush, number 40, the jammer from Montreal, sent to the box. It's a power jam for Dutchland. Only 2 Montreal blockers on the track. And V Diva,
Smack Daddy. Smack Daddy gets the worst of that one. V Diva picks up another 5. Dutchland going to slow this thing down now with Rum and Choke and Renegade Revan out there. Smack Daddy trying to hold off V Diva. She just can't quite do it, man.
No. Well, V Diva's got a lot of power in her.
5-point grand slam. How many more can V Diva get? She pirouettes, she gets through and calls it off.
That was a fun little move there, a little pirouette. She almost held on to it. That would have been pretty cool, right?
Did she pick up the 5?
Yes, she did.
She did, Bet. How about that? You know, and plays like that are why. If you are a Derby fan and you're watching at home, you really want to consider buying the high-def feed to get bouts from all of the action this weekend on demand. You pay one price for the high-definition feed, and you can access these bouts in perpetuity.
Wow, and there goes number 6021 Nash Villain with a little hop, skip, and a jump around the outside, and she is already back for a scoring pass. Gets knocked down by the Montreal blockers, but she's going to get a little help from her friends. And Montreal doing a pretty good job there.
Nash Villain called off for a minor cut. It's her 4th.
Yep.
And
here comes Georgia W. Tush, number 40 for Montreal, out of the box because Nash Villain had to go in. And now Montreal gets a shot at the power jam. Only 2 blockers for Dutchland on the track.
And Bella Loblosi with a shot on Georgia W. Tush. But Montreal actually content with just running some clock right now. I know Georgia W. Tush wants to pick up some points. But with the Dutchland jammer in the box, Georgia W. Tush isn't going to take any chances, Bet.
No way. And, you know, she puts her heart on the line every time.
Georgia W. Tush engaging the pack.
And she is trying to get on the inside of Rum and Choke, number 1234. And she gets through. That's a 5-point pass for Montreal.
And Rum and Choke out there along with Bella Loblosi for Dutchland. And they're doing all they can, Bet, but with only 2, it's pretty tough.
You know, they are trying to capture somebody, and it looks like they're trying to get Bella, number 99, and slow her down.
Twisted Scissors back on the track, and Nash Villain out of the penalty box with something to prove. Let's see whether she can get around the Montreal blockers. She's got Little Mama, number 2, to beat, and Little Mama rides her out.
But Little Mama goes out of bounds too, so Nash Villain could have come right back in there. I don't think she noticed it, though, and so she did come in behind Little Mama. Now she gets knocked to the inside by Smack Daddy, number 3X, and that jam is over. No lead on that one. It went the full 2 minutes.
And Montreal with a 99-point lead, 9:15 left. Tell you what, we've seen some great action in this one. We have a timeout called by Montreal. We want to thank Dr. Hauschka, the W WFTDA's official bruise healer. Lose the bruise with Dr. Hauschka's Ouch Aid. You ever used that, Bet?
I do, and I actually use quite a few of their products, and I love Dr. Hauschka. Wait. You know, they're based in Europe, so we got plenty of it in London. Trust me.
Well, I trust you implicitly.
Ladies know about this stuff,
the,
right?
The integrity of the British mindset is something that's always forefront.
Although you may be wondering why I don't sound British.
Yeah, I'm wondering about that.
Actually, I'm from Los Angeles originally, but trust me, I do live in London. I swear. It's real.
V Diva going up against T Lou. V Diva, number 1818. T Lou with one of those onomatopoetic name or numbers. A double double A double O U.
It's hard to say, isn't it?
It's easier to say.
It doesn't roll off the tongue.
T Lou with a couple of big jams to her credit in this one. Of course, V Diva with the Rockets for Skates. We're going to see what can go on here again. Montreal using the same strategy against V Diva, setting that wall up right up against the jam line.
And you probably saw this used to great effect by Philly in their game against London and in their game today with Charm City. Lining up on their knee right in front of those jammers puts them in a great position to knock and hold them right off the bat. Oh, V Diva getting sent to the box.
And there again, it's one of those things that it's frustration on the part of V Diva. She knows she's got the speed. She knows she's got the power. And just one too many shots into the back of that wall, and she picks up the penalty.
And that was for a high block. And, you know, she's tall, so that is not hard for her to get if she's in the wrong position. Unfortunately, sometimes that's just the way it is. If you're really tall or really short, you tend to get the low block or the high block. Meanwhile, T. Lou, A00U, is through that pack. Had a tough time getting through there a little bit. And you can see Montreal is like holding that outside, trying to get the 20-foot call. And now they're going to try and get up there and break up the Dutchland blockers a bit, try to help out T. Lou.
T. Lou goes down at the hands of Hillbilly Hellcat. And well, this is the last stand for Dutchland right now. They have to hold off T. Lou. Twisted Scissors is out there along with Skid Ho, Milk Maiden, and Hillbilly Hellcat, 12-18. But T. Lou getting through.
And number 12-18, Hillbilly Hellcat, was captured there for a few moments by Montreal.
V Diva back on the track, and she's trying to hold off T. Lou right now as another Montreal skater is going to have to go in the box. This is an interesting little strategic move here. I don't understand it quite frankly, but
look, it worked.
V Diva baiting T. Lou into making the first move, and then she countered punches, and just like that, as I said yesterday, Lou's trying to call it off. Skid Ho is able to say hello in turn number two.
Almost a little late on that block, but I think she got away with it. Number 18, Skid Ho, mean old block on T. Lou there.
And
very
this,
effective.
This next jam is brought to you by Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing solutions, along with Adam Wheels, the official wheel of the WFTDA. And now they're lining up on their knees at the pivot line, trying to spring the jammers, and it works for Renegade Raven for Dutchland. 9:35, Renegade Raven in her second jam of this period.
She had a couple jams actually that were to great effect, and so they're going to give her another shot. Meanwhile, 516 Iron Wench trying to chase up behind her. She's going to do her best to get past.
Renegade Raven gets an assist by Nashville, and she's out in front. She picks up four, but Iron Wench, the top jammer for Montreal today.
Hopping around 12:34, Roman Choke there at the end.
Iron Wench is just a force to be reckoned with, but Renegade Raven makes a four-point pass of her own. Nash Villain in the back now, and Renegade Raven calls it off. Time of the essence for Dutchland.
Absolutely. We've only got 5 minutes, 58 seconds left on the clock, and the score is 204 to 101. I'm not sure that Dutchland's going to make it up, but they're going to give it a shot, and they definitely got pride on the line here, and they want to score as many points and go out in style from this game.
How about it? We got number 40 versus number 40. Georgia W. Tush, 44 Montreal, going up against number 40 Twisted Scissors for Dutchland.
I think this might be our first jam for Twisted Scissors, if I'm not mistaken.
I believe so. And Georgia W. Tush is, she's not only been jamming effectively tonight, but she's been a major force in the pack for Montreal as well, Bet.
Yeah, historically always been that way. One of the founders of the Montreal Roller Derby League as well. Oh, very slow pack. Very, a lot of blocking going on there. Georgia trying to break through at the front now, finally.
And she gets a free pass as Skid Ho and Hillbilly Hellcat have to let her go. And Twisted Scissors called off.
Power jam for Montreal. Not what Dutchland wanted right here. And, wow, Georgia W. Tush almost took that inside line. It looks like she just did a track cut.
She's called for a track cut. It's a major.
I don't think they've given her a major.
It was not. I saw that one finger come out by the official, and I thought we had a major track cut. My bad. She's going to be able to keep skating, and all Twisted Scissors can do is watch from the penalty box.
And there she goes. That's a scoring pass for Georgia W. Tush, number 40, with 5 points for Montreal on the board from that pass alone. And here she comes again, getting a little help from 4-5-4.
What body control by Georgia W. Tush. Going into turn number three there, she kept her feet underneath her, but she just wormed her hips around the Milk Maiden up front, and that was unbelievable.
Doing a great job at doing a little extra offensive blocking of her own, helping to make her own holes, and she gets right past number 12, Milk Maiden there at the front.
I like what you said about making her own holes. I'm really impressed by Georgia W. Tush's ability to dance on her skates.
Absolutely. And meanwhile, the Dutchland jammer, number 40, Scissors, is out, but it's too late. No scoring pass for her, as Georgia calls it.
And that will probably seal the fate of Dutchland. 3:25 left. We have a timeout called, but Montreal with a commanding 225-101 lead. This next jam's brought to you by Rydell Skates, proud partner and the official skate of the WFTDA, along with Spenland Media. You need it, we make it. Apparel, websites, and that famous rules app, Bet.
The one that I don't have on my phone.
Well, I'm sure that'll change in a matter of minutes.
Yes,
as soon as
absolutely.
We get done. As soon as we get done. Do you have a bracket app on your phone, Bet?
No, I don't.
Well, brackets are on everybody's mind since it is WFTDA playoff time, and the bracket game is in full swing at WFTDA.com. You can go online and make your picks. Now, you're not going to be able to win the grand prize because you can't very well pick the East Region playoff brackets now, but you can continue your fun, and if you haven't already put your brackets in, go to WFTDA.com and you can fill out your brackets for the other region playoffs along with the championships.
And it looks like we're getting ready to start here. Everybody lining up very strategically right by that jammer line. 18-18 V Diva jamming for Dutchland. And I think we have, I think it's Iron Wench. I can't quite see her yet.
Iron Wench is 5-16 for, and V Diva
right around the outside.
But it's T. Lou, actually.
Oh, it's T. Lou. A does. 0-0 U. Once again, doesn't roll off the tongue. Oh, no.
T. Lou called off the track. That's going to put V. Diva in a power jam, and all Montreal can do is try to run away with this pack.
They're trying to outrace those Dutchland blockers.
And that's Rum and Choke, 12:34 now, trying to get in there along with Bella Loblosi and create some space for V. Diva. They do.
Rum and Choke gets in there and tries to give a little help to V. Diva. V-Diva battling on her own against 289. She's greater, and she gets through. 5 points for V-Diva.
V-Diva digging deep now at the end of the bout to try to get back into the pack as soon as possible. And Dutchland has Lil Mama caught in the back there. Bella Loblosi continues to hold her off.
Oh.
V-Diva tries to get around, but she can't. She's knocked out by number 86, Lady J. And because of that, V-Diva's going to call it off.
She almost made it, but she did put a skate on the inside of the line, and then she had to either come back in, and instead she decided to call it off and give it another try here. And I think she might be getting a little bit tired there.
There you see Hillbilly Hellcat 12-18 along with V-Diva as we have another official's time out called. We also want to thank 5on5 Magazine. If you haven't checked it out, you can look at it online at www.5on5.com. 5on5 Magazine is the official magazine of WFTDA.
And actually, I think that was a Montreal timeout. They probably just want to make sure that they all are in the same loop for the end of this game here, because we've only got 2 minutes and 8 seconds left on the clock.
Montreal 225. Dutchland 109, and Montreal shows the benefit of playing that tough schedule this year, Bet.
Oh, they played so many games. We were kind of in awe in London. I wish we could play that many games with our travel team. But yeah, it really shows, because every time they played somebody that was just like an amazing team and supposedly better than them, they either did way better than everyone thought or they just learned so much.
Montreal played 18 games this year. Their overall record was 13-5. They went on the road to Oly, Rat City, Jet City, and just unbelievable competition. They played at Houston, or they played Houston, and only lost by, actually they won,
Texas.
They won against Houston 126-121. That must have been a heck of a bout.
It looks like timeout is over, so we are going to get started with what is probably the second to last jam, potentially. And we are starting with a Dutchland power jam here.
That's 9:35, Renegade Raven on the jam line for the Dutchland All-Stars. She's going to try to get all she can. At least bring this thing within 100.
Renegade Raven, also one of those jammers who is quite effective at blocking as she goes through the pack and making her own holes. Let's see if she could do that this time. Easily around 3X Smack Daddy and past Jess Bandit number 8. She is totally through. Dutchland doing a great job of holding back Smack Daddy and slowing that pack down. Meanwhile, T. Lou coming out of the box as the jammer from Montreal. She's doing a little defensive jammer action. Doesn't quite work.
Renegade Raven can't quite get around number 8, Jess Bandit. She and Jess Bandit goes back to make Renegade Raven go back as well. Now T. Lou is off to the races.
She did not get lead jammer there because she had a minor track cut on her way out of the pack.
That's a 5-point pass for Renegade Raven, who calls it off. And we've got the clock ticking down now. That's 1:15 for Dutchland, 2:25 for Montreal. This next jam will be brought to you by Sin City Skates. Sin City Skates is ready to fix your gear, or hey, they'll chat with you about new stuff too.
I have a feeling that Dutchland might be trying to get that point differential down below 100, because they are pushing really hard in these last few jams, and they are like, hey, you know what? Let's go out in style here, folks.
You bet. And speaking of style, that is Skid Ho number 18 getting through for lead jammer, and the yeoman jammer for Montreal, number 516, Iron Wench.
And Iron Wench trying to power around, but it doesn't matter. Skid Ho reaches that pack first. She's right through the back of it and right through the front. She calls it immediately.
V-Diva and Iron Wench getting into a little bit extracurricular. Not really extracurricular in the back, but they are both skating like they mean it. Bet.
Absolutely. Well, it's the end of a hard-fought bout, and sometimes people get a little adrenaline flowing, and they're like, hey, I'm going to go for that hit. Why not? We've got 26 seconds left, and obviously we've got a timeout call here as the clock has stopped.
9:35, Renegade Raven in the orange with the star, number 40. for Montreal is Georgia W. Tush going to take it home for the New Skids. This next jam, and probably what will be the final jam, is brought to you by Vanilla Derby. Let Vanilla Derby take you to success with their brand new top grain leather, Renegade, and straitjacket boots.
And Dutchland blockers lining up at the front there. Oh, looks like Montreal is going to take that knee and try to get it going as quickly as possible.
Well, you can't blame them for that. And the jam timer says, I like what I see, and we're getting ready to go. 26 minutes left on the period clock.
26 seconds, sorry.
26 seconds, I guess.
It's a whole new period. Okay, and here we go. Immediate start, Montreal trying to slow it down. They don't care if nobody scores any points in this jam. Montreal is going to just sit there. It's going to be a completely stationary jam until somebody gets going.
Well, the whistle hasn't blown.
There
now
it goes.
It's blown.
Oh, Georgia W. Tush immediately goes down to a knee and trying to get through.
Renegade Raven wants to get through for Dutchland, but she's being held off by number two, Little Mama, and a solid shot by number 40. Jammer shot by Georgia W. Tush. Now Renegade Raven looking for the inside.
Little Mama all over her. Number two, she's little and mighty.
She is holding off Renegade Raven. Nobody's going to get through this pack, I don't think. Although the jam clock continues, the period clock has expired, and we'll see now. Looks like Renegade Raven might have a chance at it, but she's got the pivot to beat, and yeah, that's none other than number eight, Jess Bandit. Renegade Raven will be, oh, and how about this for a development? George W. Tush called off. Dutchland's going to finish this one in a power jam.
High block on Georgia W. Tush. She goes to the box. Last chance for Dutchland to score. Here comes Renegade Raven up to the back. Little Mama, Jess Bandit, and Smack Daddy trying to hold down the defensive wall.
And Little Mama says, well, how about that one, Renegade Raven? Nash Villain tries to break things up, and she's successful. Little Mama goes down for a second. Now Renegade Raven running on the outside, but she gets a shot from Smack Daddy, but she stays on her feet, picks up five.
I think Dutchland might make their goal, if indeed it was, to get that points differential down below 100. They need two more points.
Number eight in the jammer killing spot right now, and that is exactly what happened as Renegade Raven goes off for a major back block.
Wow.
Jess Bandit held her ground. That will spring Georgia W. Tush from the penalty box. She's going to have to skate halfway around the world to get back behind the rest of the pack.
And that is it. The crowd is going absolutely wild here. A lot of Montreal fans, obviously. That was a great game.
101 point win for Montreal, as you see the crowd go out and give a little love to both of these teams. Montreal and Dutchland slapping hands, giving each other the high five bet. And Montreal had to be considered the favorite in this one, and they showed why.
Yeah, definitely. And I think that Dutchland gave a really good effort, though. And, you know, as they often say, it's a cliche. The scoreline doesn't always reflect the play on the track. Dutchland played a hard game. They have some great jammers. V Diva just powers around that track. And Renegade Raven showing some great jamming in the second half of the game there.
And the blocking was superb for Dutchland up in front as far as holding the jammers back. But springing their own jammer from time to time was a little erratic. Again,
yep,
though, you can't win when your jammers are sitting in the penalty box. And I know some of that. But, we are so glad to be here bringing you this entire week of 2011 WFTDA region playoff action. We're in the East region, of course, and DVDs will be available online at the WFTDA store of all of these bouts, but if you are watching online and you decide to buy the HD feed, the high def feed, which we do recommend, I mean, it looks pretty darn good, in the low def version, but high def, I'm looking at the high def feed right now. I mean, it is unbelievable.
It's crisp.
It is. It's crisp, crystal clear. And if you buy that high def feed for a one-time fee, you get the bouts of this tournament on demand.
So you can wake up at 2 in the morning and go, wow, you know what? I really want to see that Charm Philly bat again. Sweet. Press play.
Press play, or even just to see a greatest hits, a recap of some of these great plays. And we saw a couple just in this bout,
Bet. Yep. Don't forget to stick around, because the next bout coming up is London versus Boston. It's like the Empire Strikes Back. The Revolutionary War fought again. What other cliches can we come up with?
The Tea Party.
The Tea Party.
Yeah, that's a hot topic on this side of the Atlantic these days.
We don't know what that's about over in London.
Well,
in London, we don't know what that's about.
Well, you're probably lucky. We're not going to talk politics here, but in any case, the last thing I'm going to say on that subject is, as the dancing Technicolor Titan groups go by celebrating that Montreal win, is we want to thank our sponsors for tonight's Boutcast. Honest Tea, Flying Dog Beer, the official beer of the 2011 WFTDA East Regional Playoffs, and Vitamin Water. Vitamin Water's been donating hydration to the skaters and officials all weekend long, Bet.
Yummy, yummy. You know, we didn't have Vitamin Water in the UK when I first moved there from America, and then a couple years ago they brought it over, and you should have seen the ecstatic look on my face.
It made all the difference. You decided you'd stay.
Yes.
That's why you became a citizen.
Not yet. I'm gonna get my citizenship this year, and it is all down to the Vitamin Water, I will say.
All right. Well, Bet, it's been a little slice of heaven broadcasting this game with you, and we certainly want to thank you at home for joining us on this Blaze streaming media production of the WFTDA East Region Playoffs. This is Max the Axe.
And Bet Noir.
And we are signing off. Coming up next, Boston versus London.
Ooh, ooh. Thank you, and see you later.